Hello, I'm Morgan. I joined Akinio as a product manager 3 years ago. My goal here is to ease the way you structure your catalogs, but also to help you increase your productivity. A lot of your daily tasks are repetitive and could be automatized. When we reached out to you during your research phase, this is one of the stories we heard. Every day, when you start working in your Akinio PIM, you open your product grid with a selection of new products to work on. Let's say some shoes. You start enriching their attributes, and especially the heel type. This attribute value defines the category as well. Once the attribute value is set, then you can categorize the shoe. And there you go, you start categorizing shoes manually, depending on the heel type you just set. And this is what you do over and over every day. Our team made it a priority to help you dedicate your precious time to high-value tasks, such as writing compelling descriptions. This is why we worked on automatizing these repetitive actions from our rules engine. I can imagine what you may be thinking right now. Well, I already know this feature, and actually, I never really understood how this rules engine worked, especially because it requires to write and import YAML files. You're right, this feature is almost 5 years old. Indeed, the rules engine was released in Akinio 1.3. It was initially designed for IT people. To create or edit rules, you had to update a scary-looking YAML file and then import it in the PIM. At Akinio, we wanted to empower you, product marketers, even further. That's why we decided to create a dedicated interface where you will be completely autonomous. We called it the Rules Builder. But before diving into this new feature, let's have a look at some other great improvements we worked on. In a few clicks, every Akinio user is able to create or edit rules very easily. It no longer matters if you have a technical profile or a more operational one. All you need is the appropriate rights. Indeed, it's possible to define a restricted number of users for the Rules Builder. Let's take a look at the Rules Grid now. We revamped it to let you see all the essentials at a glance. For instance, you can easily see the priority level of a rule. It means that the rule with the highest priority will be executed first. And that's not it. Rules now have a status and a label. Thanks to the status, you can enable or disable a rule. If the rule is disabled, it will not be executed. This can be very useful if you want to create a draft version of your rule. Labels, on the other hand, will allow you to retrieve your rule and know what it does. The label can be translated into all your activated locales. How about we take a look at it together? I'm delighted to introduce you what we worked on with my team. Building a rule is a two-step process. First, you must define your product selection, also known as the conditions, and then the actions you want to launch on these products or product models. We highly recommend that you limit the scope of your rule to the finest selection of products. This way, you will really benefit from the power of the rules engine to increase your product data quality. Let me explain it another way. Would it make sense to run a rule to indicate the height of heels on t-shirts? To be really specific, use as many conditions as you want among your attribute list and the system filters. Then, add one or several actions and let the magic happen. What I'm doing now is building a rule to automatically categorize all the shoes with a high heel, meaning more than 6 cm, and that are not categorized yet. Remember, our main objective was to help you save your precious time. This is what inspired us to offer you the possibility to duplicate a rule. Let me show you. You just set a rule to edit women's t-shirts, and you realize you need the exact same one for children's t-shirts. You don't need to go through the same process all over again. First, you need to duplicate your rule, and then to set the product selection to children's t-shirts. In a couple of clicks, your new rule is ready to be enabled for your new selection of products. Let's take another example now. As you can see here, the e-commerce ready attribute is empty, and I can't manually edit it. This is normal. We want to avoid human error. To edit it, we will define a rule that will automatically set the value to yes, if the product is complete on this specific channel and locale. Once the rule is executed, the value is set to yes. The Rules Engine also allows you to avoid having empty attribute values. For example, if the shipping weight is empty, but the product weight isn't, then the product weight can be copied to the shipping weight attribute very easily. The Rules Engine can also calculate the volume of your shoebox based on three other attribute values: package height, width, and depth. And we can imagine another attribute where we will calculate how many of these shoeboxes we can have on one pallet depending on the volume of the shoebox. I will take another example to show you the power of the Rules Engine. Let's say that you manually filled all the main attributes of a t-shirt: the brand, the size, the material, the fit, and so on. You would like to have a product overview gathering all these attribute values. To do so, you will have to copy-paste each value in your product overview attributes and check every day that none of these values has changed. And if something changed, you will have to manually fix it. As you can imagine, it's a heavy task, very repetitive and time-consuming. It's a problem solved thanks to the Rules Engine. As all these values have already been set in the product sheet, the Rules Engine can use them to automatically populate the product overview attributes. Let's see how the rules look like. As you can see here, I already created a bunch of rules in order to fill the product overview attributes. I've been able to define the rules execution order thanks to their priority. This way, the initiation rule will be executed first in order to clear the value if it already exists, so that the value always starts with overview. Don't be surprised, I use some HTML tags in order to have a list of bullet points and a bold font. You may need some help from a technical teammate if you wish to reproduce it. Then, I've set up one rule per attribute I want to concatenate in order to be sure that I won't concatenate an empty attribute. Once your rules are created and enabled, you can execute them. From the process tracker, you can now monitor execution of your rules. This way, you can track which products have been updated or not. Now that the job is over, you can see in your products the new automated description we made thanks to the Rules Engine. So, to sum up, the Rules Builder is a tool that facilitates the creation and edition of all your rules in the PIM so that everybody can automate tasks and become way more productive. Additional features such as the rules grid, the rule duplication, the rule status, or even the rule execution sumup are here as well to make your daily work easier. We had a great time this year working on all of these wonderful improvements, and I hope that you enjoy using them daily or that you will love discovering them in our other product demos. Thanks, and see you soon.